Dear students, in this video we are going to discussing about vernier caliper. The previous videos we discussed about the screw gauge and its applications. Like that, now let's see that vernier caliper. First I'll give some idea in this video. First we are going to discuss what is vernier caliper, then this diagram, then what about its least count of the vernier caliper, then what are the different types of errors produced in the vernier caliper, then how to rectify it, then how to take the reading, then general applications of vernier calipers. Okay, shall we discuss now? Yes. Listen, so first vernier caliper. Vernier caliper. Actually, this vernier caliper, another name is he called as slide caliper. So here we are using the slide scale, that is also one of the main scale and all. So it's named as slide caliper, another name. So it is based on the working principle is, that is principle of vernier. That is principle of vernier. Principle of vernier. So let's we see this diagram. Okay, actually this vernier caliper, generally its least count is 0.01 centimeter, but you know the screw gauge least count is 0.01 millimeter. Comparing with the screw gauge, this slide caliper, that is a vernier caliper, least count is less alone. It's not that much accuracy. But that is screw gauge, we can't use in all the purpose. Some purpose we can use only the vernier caliper only. So that only we are using this apparatus. Okay, while discussing how to take the reading part, you know the importance of the vernier caliper over the screw gauge. So let's see this diagram. So kindly observe that, then how to draw this diagram. Okay, first let's we draw that one main scale. This is known as slide scale. Slide scale or main scale, like this. Okay, and then so here that end of the main scale, one strips are there. Okay, so while discussing the application part, I will explain the uses of this strip. Then this is the main scale, just I mention as M. Okay, then after that, actually this main scale is, the main scale is fixed one, it is not movable. Okay, then one more thing, in the main scale each and every division's value we called as one main scale division. One main scale division, each main scale division's value, that is 1 millimeter, that is 1 MSD, that is 1 millimeter. This is like ordinary scale. Okay, after complete the diagram, I mentioned the reading. Then next, the upper part of the, or on the main scale, one scale is there, that is movable scale. So please listen. So that scale, I draw here. So here one line, here one line. Okay, actually this part is the vernier scale diagram. So this vernier scale, it is present in between the gap of the main scale. Actually this is the vernier scale. So this box is the vernier scale. So just I mention as V for understanding purpose. Okay, so in the vernier scale actually only 10 divisions are there. So 0 1 2 3 4 5 0 1 2 3 4 5, again 6 7 8 9 10. So totally 10 divisions are there. Okay, so in the vernier scale, this is vernier scale, here totally 10 divisions are there. So number of vernier scale division is 10. So this is one of the important point. After that, it will be connected with the jaws, that is upper jaw, and then below jaw, the two parts are there. So please listen. So the first I draw the upper part. So upper part diagram. Okay. Okay, so like that, nearby I can draw the one more part like this. Okay, then again it will be continue like this. So kindly observe the diagram. So it will be attached with the main scale. It's a main scale. So listen. So it's a main scale part. It's a main scale part. Then again, okay, this part enough. This line joined like this. So these are the two jaws. Okay, that one is the down part. I can represent by A and B. The upper part jaws, I can represent by P and Q. Okay. Then now I can mention the reading. So in the main scale, such as ordinary scale, I said, so starting from 0 1 2 3 4 5 1 2 3 4 5, so 1 centimeter. So like that, 2 centimeter, 3 centimeter, 4 centimeter, 5 centimeter, 6 centimeter, approximately this move to 15 centimeter. So here one screw is there. It is a screw. If you adjust this screw, this vernier scale is movable on the main scale, left and right. Okay. Before going to take the reading, if you adjust this screw, this B end move to attach with the A end. After that, we want to focus vernier scale and main scale. We should find whether any zero errors are available or not. If we have any error, we want to rectify that with the calculation. Then we want to keep the material in between the gap of A and B. Then we want to take the reading. Okay, suppose if I take one sphere or one ball dress ball, so I want to find the diameter of this ball. Okay, I want to find the diameter of the ball. So we want to keep it in between the two jaws. Okay, suppose let I take, if you want to find the inner radius, outer radius means, okay, outer radius means we want to, or outer diameter means we want to use A in between the A and B gap. Suppose if you want to find the inner diameter of the hollow cylinder, we want to kept the cylinder, the upper part of P and Q. For example, this is that cylinder. So I kept the cylinder on P and Q. So please listen. See that the cylinder. Okay. So now I can insert the cylinder on P and Q. So this method, which is used to measure that inner part of the or inner diameter of the hollow cylinder. Okay, but here in between A and B means we can find that outer diameter of the hollow cylinder or that diameter of the spherical ball, like that application for different purpose is using. Suppose, so this is the first part. We can find the outer diameter. It is the second part. We can find the inner diameter. Suppose, let us imagine, let's take one box. Okay, so please listen. Let's take one box or any wooden block. Let us take one eraser, your eraser, you know. Suppose, let us imagine here one holes are there already. Let us imagine one holes are there. This is the hole. Okay, one holes are there. Maybe we want to find this depth of the hole. So for this purpose, we can insert this whole part, the back side of the vernier caliper. So we want to insert the whole part here. Appa diagram eppadi irukum? Let us imagine. That's all. So this is that whole part. The whole part here. So we can find the depth of the hole or the depth of the bore. Okay, so this is one of the third application, the third purpose of vernier caliper. Okay students, now you know what is vernier caliper, then what about the structure, what are the scales are present in the vernier caliper, then how to use the vernier caliper with the specific parts. Okay, now we are going to discuss how to get this least count, that is 0.01 centimeter. Shall we see now?
Yes.
Listen, students. First, we are going to find the least count of the vernier caliper. Actually, the least count of the vernier caliper, the main formula is least count equal to 1 main scale division minus 1 vernier scale division. Okay. First, I want to give the clear idea about main scale division and vernier scale division. That means each main scale division and each vernier scale division. Okay. Please listen the, see the, observe the diagram. Listen, in the diagram, first main scale division. So, you know already, each division is on the main scale. For example, here 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, this is, you know, 1 centimeter. This 1 centimeter divided into 10 parts. So, each part, you know, that is 1 millimeter. So, now you know, 1 main scale division is nothing but 1 millimeter. So, this is no issues. And then, next, what about 1 vernier scale division value? Okay. So, இது எப்படி பார்க்கணும் அப்படினா, okay, this 10 lines of main scale division, sorry, this 10 lines of vernier scale division, okay, I can draw here, only vernier scale only I draw here, this is vernier scale part alone, here you know 10 lines are there, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, okay. This vernier scale is comparing with the main scale. This is main scale. In the main scale, how much line is balanced with, is covered with the vernier scale. So, in the, for example, in the main scale, 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, then 10. So, for example, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, up to here, 1 centimeter. It's, you know, it's 1 centimeter. 1 centimeter. Okay. So, 0, 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, 0.6, 0.7, 0.8, 0.9, 1. Okay. But, please listen, இங்க 10 lines இருக்கு, okay, that means 10 lines of vernier scale division, 10 lines of vernier scale division equal to, அப்பா பாருங்க, இந்த 10 lines, இங்க எத்தன lines cover பண்டுதுன் பாகும், okay, இங்க 10 lines இருக்கு, but இங்க பார்த்தீங்கனா, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 lines only cover, அப்பா, 10 vernier scale divisions line is equal to 9 main scale division line. So, these two points are important. By using these two points only, we are going to find the least count of the vernier caliper. Okay. So, this value, these two value, we can use that formula. We can use in the formula. So, please listen. So, please listen, students. So, now you know one main scale division. One main scale division. So, one main scale division, that is, you know, 1 millimeter. That is, each main scale division is 1 millimeter. Minus 1 VSD, 1 vernier scale division, how much? But you know already, what is that? 10 vernier scale division is equal to 9 main scale division. 10 vernier scale division equal to 9 MSD. அப்பா, 1 VSD what? 1 VSD. அப்பா, என்னாவும் 1 VSD இனா, just VSD மட்டு இங்க இருக்கு. அப்பா, 10 இந்தான் வந்துத்துனா, divide by ஆயிருமா? So, 9 by 10 MSD. Therefore, 1 vernier scale division equal to 9 by 10. MSD means, that is main scale division. Main scale division, how much already I told you? That is millimeter, 1 millimeter. So, simply I can write millimeter. Okay. Because 1 MSD is millimeter. So, MSD is millimeter. So, now 1 MSD also we found. Then one VST also we found. So this one VST value we can apply it here. So one VST is how much? 9 by 10 millimeter. So 9 by 10 millimeter. Therefore, least count is equal to 10 into 1 millimeter is 10 millimeter minus 9 millimeter, the whole divided by 10. 10 millimeter minus 9 millimeter, that is equal to 1 millimeter, then divide by 10. Therefore, least count equal to 1 by 10, we can write 0.1 millimeter. Therefore, least count is equal to 0.1 millimeter, we can write 10 power minus 3 meter. That is also we can write 10 power minus 1 into 10 power minus 2 meter. This 10 power minus 3 we can split as 10 power minus 1, 10 power minus 2. Therefore, least count equal to 0.1 into 10 power minus 1, we can write 0.01. 10 power minus 2 meter, that is, you know, centimeter. So this is the least count of the vernier caliper. By using the formula, that is 1 MST minus 1 VSD, we found least count of the vernier caliper is 0.01 centimeter. Okay. So now you know by using the formula 1 MSD minus 1 VSD. So you know already the screw gauge. The screw gauge least count short formula, you know, least count is equal to pitch value divided by number of head scale division. Okay, so this is the formula from screw gauge. So like this, one more formula is here in the vernier caliper. Easily we can find within one step we can find the least count. So that is the second method. So this is the method number one. So method number two I can explain now. It's very easy. Least count is equal to, okay, in the screw gauge, pitch value, pitch scale, like that. Here in the vernier caliper is, that is main scale division. So main scale division divide by either number of head scale, inga number of vernier scale, number of vernier scale division. Okay, so this is the formula. So 1 MST, so this is the formula. Okay, so therefore, least count equal to 1 MSD. 1 MSD means, you know, that is 1 millimeter divided by number of vernier scale division, how much? 10. See that 1 by 10 millimeter. 1 divided by 10 millimeter. See that the same steps here. 1 by 10 millimeter, 1 by 10 millimeter. So it should be is equal to 0.01 centimeter. So we can find the same value easily within one step. Okay students, now you know how to find the least count of the vernier caliper. Okay. We are going to discuss what are the different types of zero errors produced in the vernier caliper, then how to rectify. Let's see. Listen students, now we can find the different types of zero error. So please listen, types of zero error in vernier caliper. So already you know the idea from the screw gauge also. So here also to produce three types of zero error. That first one is nil error. That means no zero error. Next, positive zero error. Next, negative zero error. Okay. So before going to discuss or before going to find the error, we must observe the apparatus. Let's see the apparatus. Before going to take the reading by using this material like a sphere, hollow cylinder, like this wooden box something. Okay, so the screw is there. We want to adjust the screw. While adjusting the screw, this B end is contact with the A end. So now we didn't use any materials here. So what happened? If you adjust the screw, this B end is going to contact with the B end, as well as this Q end also is contact with the P end. At the time, this edge, you know, it is move backside. I mean, it is move behind the M. That is a main scale. Okay, this is also move behind the M. Okay, at the time, it will not visible. Okay, the Q is contact with P, B is contact with A, and this line, I mean, this strip will not visible. So in that situation, we want to focus vernier scale and main scale. Okay, so then we want to decide what kind of errors present in the vernier caliper. So let's see now one by one. So after contact to end, we want to focus vernier scale and main scale. Suppose this is vernier scale, this one is the main scale. So here zero of the vernier, as usual, 1 2 3 4 5 1 2 3 4 5, 10 lines are there. Then this is the main scale, so main scale zero here. For understanding purpose, I can write here. Okay, so this line zero of the main scale, then 1 2 3 4 5, so like that is moving. Okay, so here the point is zero of the main scale or zero of the vernier is coincident with the zero of the main scale. Zero of the vernier scale is coincident with zero of the main scale. So this situation is exposed nil error. So zero error is nil. So zero correction also nil. That's all. So this is the way to find nil error. Most of the vernier caliper, nil error only is available. Not like a screw gauge, okay, right? But it is a rare case. Positive error and a negative error is present in the vernier caliper. Okay, mostly nil error alone. Okay, now let's we see the positive error. How to find the positive error? Again, let's we focus the vernier scale and main scale. Vernier scale and main scale. For example, first I draw the main scale. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1 centimeter. So like that is moving. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 2. Like that is going. Okay. It's a main scale. Suppose it is a vernier scale. Vernier scale. See that 0 is starting from here. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10th line. So something like this. Okay. So if you focus here, okay, இப்போ ஒரு இது மாதிரி நினைச்சிங்க, ஒரு graph மாதிரி நினைச்சிங்க. Graphல, this is for example y axis. This is for example x axis. Okay. இப்போ y axis க்கு right side இருந்துச்சுன்னா, some value இருந்துச்சுன்னா, y axis க்கு right side some value இருந்தா, it should be the positive. Okay. Like that. This is like a axis. Okay, this axis right side, this axis right side is 0 is available. So this is positive error. Okay, as a definition, how we can say, as a definition, we can say 0 of the vernier is right from zero of the mean. Zero of the vernier scale is right from the zero of the main scale. தெரியுதா? பாருங்க zero of the mean இங்க இருக்கு. ஆனா வெர்னியர் எங்க இருக்கு? இதிலிருந்து ரைட்ல இருக்கு. இல்லையா? பாருங்க ரைட்ல போகுது. இங்க இருக்கு. ஓகே? So it is a right side. ஓகே? It is a right side. So zero of the vernier scale is right from the zero of the main scale. So that is known as positive error. So first I can write the general formula for positive error. So zero error is equal to, it is a positive. Okay, so we can write the coincident value directly. That value I don't know, that is a y into least count. So zero error is equal to y. So now the which value is coincident? Which value coincident? இது எப்படி சார் பார்க்கறது அப்படினா, இந்த வெர்னியர் காலிஃபர்ல, சாரி இந்த வெர்னியர் ஸ்கேல்ல டோட்டலா 10 லைன்ஸ் இருக்கும். இந்த 10 லைன்ல எத்தனாவது லைன் மெயின் ஸ்கேலோட கோயின்சிடென்ட் ஆகுதுன்னு பார்க்கணும். ஓகே சரி, இது நீங்கள் ஒரிஜினல் வெர்னியர் காலிஃபர்ல பார்த்தீங்கன்னா நல்லாவே பார்க்கலாம். ஓகேவா? சம்டைம்ஸ் கொஞ்சம் டிஃபிகல்ட்டாக இருந்தது, வி கேன் யூஸ் தி மேக்னிஃபைங் கிளாஸ், வி கேன் அப்சர்வ். ஓகே, ஸோ அப்போ நம்ம என்ன பண்ணுறோம்னா இப்போ ஃபோக்கஸிங் வந்து பார்க்குறோம். ஓகே, இப்போ ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள் ஹியர் எனக்கு இந்த இடத்துல ஒரு இந்த லைன்ஸ் கோயின்சிடென்ட் ஆகிற மாதிரி தெரியுது. ஓகே, ஸோ திஸ் லைன், ஸோ திஸ் லைன் எத்தனாவதுன்னு பார்த்தீங்கன்னா ஜீரோ. இது வந்து ஃபிஃப்த் லைன், சிக்ஸ்த் லைன் வில் பி கோயின்சிடென்ட் ஃபார் மீ, சிக்ஸ்த் லைன். அப்போ ஒய் வேல்யூ இஸ் சிக்ஸு இன்ட்டு லீஸ் கவுண்ட் ஆஃப் தி வெர்னியர் காலிஃபர் இன்னும் 0.01 சென்டிமீட்டர். ஸோ ஜீரோ எரர் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு 0.06 சென்டிமீட்டர். திஸ் இஸ் ஜீரோ எரர். ஸோ ஆல்ரெடி யூனோ ஜீரோ எரர் அண்ட் ஜீரோ கரெக்ஷன் இஸ் ஆப்போசிட் பட் சேம் மேக்னிடியூட். ஸோ ஜீரோ கரெக்ஷன் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு மைனஸ் 0.06 சென்டிமீட்டர். ஸோ நவ் த ஜீரோ கரெக்ஷன் வி ஃபவுண்ட். ஓகே, இப்போ உங்களுக்கு பாசிட்டிவ் எரர் தெரிஞ்சிருக்கும், ஸோ அதனால் நெகட்டிவ் எரர் கொஞ்சம் ஈஸியாக தான் இருக்கும். ஸோ ப்ளீஸ் லிசன். ஓகே, அகெயின் யூ வாண்ட் டு யூஸ் த ஃபஸ்ட்டு வெர்னியர் ஸ்கேல். ஓகே, வெர்னியர் ஸ்கேல், நெக்ஸ்ட்டு இட் இஸ் அ மெயின் ஸ்கேல். ஸோ இதில் அகெயின் ஃபஸ்ட்டு வி வாண்ட் டு ரைட் த மெயின் ஸ்கேல் ரீடிங் 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. ஸோ நவ் அப் டு ஹியர் 1 சென்டிமீட்டர், தென் 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. ஸோ அப் டு ஹியர் 2 சென்டிமீட்டர் இஸ் மூவிங் லைக் திஸ். ஓகே, ஸோ நவ் சி த வெர்னியர் ஸ்கேல், வெர்னியர் ஸ்கேல் ரீடிங். ஓகே, சப்போஸ் இட் இஸ் ஸ்டார்டிங் ஃப்ரம் ஹியர் 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. ஸோ இட் இஸ் அ 10th லைன். ஓகே, ஸோ ப்ளீஸ் லிசன் ஹியர் இந்த பாசிட்டிவ் எரர் டெஃபனிஷன். யூனோ த ஜீரோ ஆஃப் தி வெர்னியர் ஈஸ் ரைட் ஃப்ரம் தி ஜீரோ ஆஃப் தி மெயின் ஸ்கேல், பட் ஹியர் ஜீரோ ஆஃப் தி வெர்னியர் ஈஸ் லெஃப்ட் ஃப்ரம் சி த டேரோ மார் லெஃப்ட் ஃப்ரம் ஜீரோ ஆஃப் தி மெயின் ஸ்கேல். ஸோ ஹியர் த லெஃப்ட் சைடு இட்ஸ் அ லெஃப்ட், பட் ஹியர் ரைட், ஹியர் லெஃப்ட். ஸோ ஐ கேன் சே ஒன் மோர் டைம், ஜீரோ ஆஃப் தி வெர்னியர் ரைட் ஃப்ரம் ஜீரோ ஆஃப் தி மெயின் ஸ்கேல், தட் இஸ் பாசிட்டிவ் எரர். பட் ஹியர் ஜீரோ ஆஃப் தி வெர்னியர் இஸ் லெஃப்ட் ஃப்ரம் ஜீரோ ஆஃப் தி மெயின் ஸ்கேல், ஸோ தட் இஸ் நெகட்டிவ் எரர். ஸோ இஃப் இட் இஸ் பாசிட்டிவ் எரர் வி கேன் ரைட் டைரக்ட்லி லைக் திஸ் ஃபார்முலா, பட் இந்த நெகட்டிவ் எரர் வி வாண்ட் டு ஃபாலோ சம் ப்ரொசீஜர். நெகட்டிவ் எரர், ஸோ புட் மைனஸ் சைன் ஃபஸ்ட்டு, தென் ஆஃப்டர் தட். So here totally how many lines are there in the vernier scale? 10 lines. So 10 minus in which line is coincident, that is y, we don't know, that is y. Then after that, as usual, least count. So this is the formula. So in this formula we can apply and find. So therefore zero error is equal to minus 10 minus, now which line? So totally 10 lines are there. In the 10th line, which line is coincident? Okay, if for example 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4th line is coincident for me. Okay, 4th line is coincident. So 4th line into least count value 0.01 centimeter. Therefore 0 error is equal to minus of 10 minus 4, that is 6. So minus 6 into 0.01 centimeter. Therefore 0 error is equal to minus 0.06 சென்டிமீட்டர். ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் ஜீரோ எரர். ஸோ லெட் சி தட் ஜீரோ கரெக்ஷன் இட் இஸ் ஆப்போசிட் பட் சேம் வேல்யூ. ஸோ பிளஸ் 0.06 centimeter. Okay students, now you know what are the different types of errors produced in the vernier caliper, such as nil error, positive error and negative error, and how to rectify it. Okay, now let's we see the how to take the reading by using the vernier caliper. Okay, shall we? Listen students, so by using the vernier caliper I'm going to find the diameter of the given spherical sphere. Okay, so first let's see this tabulation like a screw gauge model. First serial number, then after that main scale reading, that is in centimeter. Next vernier scale coincident, that is in division. After that observed reading equal to this main scale reading plus vernier scale coincident into least count. Okay, this value in centimeter. Then finally we can write correct reading, CR. Correct reading is equal to observed reading plus or minus zero correction. Okay, just to make one box. So I'm going to take five reading. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. So first, initially we want to write the right side of the table, the upper part. We want to write the datas. First, least count. Least count of this upper part is 0.01 centimeter. Next, zero error. Next, zero correction. Okay. For calculation purpose, let us imagine the most of the zero vernier caliper nil error only will come, but anyhow for calculation purpose I am take this negative error. Okay, negative error, so we want to do zero error and zero correction we want to write. So zero error is minus 0.06 centimeter, then the zero correction is opposite. So this two value I can write on the table. So now let us imagine, so the zero error is, so the negative zero error, so zero error is minus 0.06 centimeter, so zero correction is positive 0.06 centimeter. Okay, so now let's see the take the reading. So now I'm going to find the diameter of the given spherical sphere. Okay, so let us imagine, so now let's say take one small ball. So that ball is kept in between the gap of A and B. Okay, this ball I kept in between the gap of A and B. Okay, so here the ball, it's a ball. Okay, so now we want to see the reading here. First I'll see the main scale reading. Okay, main scale reading means, okay, so this zero value where showing, that is a main scale reading. This zero value where it is showing. Okay, for example only it shows. Okay, I plan to give some value. For example, the zero is where showing. Okay, for example, the first reading is 1.83. okay, so that is a main scale reading. After that we want to rotate, then again kept in between A and B, I can get the same value 1.83 again. Okay, and then one more thing I want to say. First 1.83 I got. First initially 1.83 I got. So that is a main scale reading. So first 1.83 I got. I'll write in the table first. So 1.83 I got. Next vernier scale coincident. So how to find the vernier scale coincident? After writing 1.83, here 10 lines are there. In the 10th line, which line is coincident straightly, like that we want to observe. Okay, right. So for example, I observe the third line is coincident. So the third line is coincident. So now I write on the table. So third line is coincident. Like that, I want to rotate the ball. Okay, the same way we want to take the different set of reading. So I can get the next reading is 1.83. So corresponding vernier scale coincident is again I got 3 alone. Next again rotate, I take in a different position. Again I get main scale reading is 1.83 alone. Okay. Then again I can get vernier scale division is 2. Again 1.8 enough. Okay. Because it is like ordinary scale only main scale division. So for understanding purpose, I can write 1.8 alone. Okay, then again here, the third division is coincident. The last 1.8, because it is a uniform ball only. So main scale will not vary that much level. Maybe vernier scale little bit variations will come. So that little bit variation only I mentioned. So now let's see this observed reading, how to find the observed reading. So first main scale reading is 1.8. Plus, actually 1.8 in centimeter plus vernier scale division is 3. So 3 into 0.01 centimeter. So 1.8 centimeter plus 0.03 centimeter. Therefore is equal to 1.83 centimeter. So first reading is what? 1.83 centimeter. Like that next reading also 1.83 centimeter. Next third reading is what? 1.82 centimeter. Next fourth reading what? 1.83 centimeter. Next last reading is what? 1.82 centimeter. Okay, right. Suppose if it is the zero error, so what we are going to do, we want to add. So I can write here, so 1. Correct reading, how to write the correct reading? Observed reading is 1.83 plus or minus, but this questions we do for plus only, plus 0.06. So what I get? So plus 6 add 1.8 plus 0.6 add 1.89. So this is first reading. Second reading also 1.89 will come. Third reading 1.88 will come. Next reading 1.89 will come. Next reading 1.88 will come. Okay. So first we are going to find this average value. This average value only, that is diameter of the given spherical ball in centimeter. So let's be found and write. So this diameter, the average value only diameter. So we want to add 1.89, 1.89, 1.88, 1.89, 1.88. So if you add all this value, I can get, that is 9.43. Okay, let's we want to find the average. So that is divide by 5, because total value, number of value is 5. So total value divided by number of value. So that is we can get 1.886 centimeter. So this is actually the diameter of the given ball, given spherical ball. 1.886 is a diameter. Suppose if they are asking the outer radius of the given ball, that is r is equal to this diameter divided by 2. So 1.886 divided by 2. 1.886 divided by 2. So that is the radius. So that radius value, this half of the value only radius, that is 0.943 centimeter. So this is the radius of the, this is the outer radius of the given ball. Okay. Okay, students. Suppose only nil error means this value enough. suppose nil error means there is no positive error, there is no negative error means this tabulation, so this part no need. So directly let's take this value, then take average, that is a diameter. But here according to our idea we have negative error, so we want to do this formalities. Okay students, so now you know how to take the reading by using the spherical ball. Okay, so finally let's we see what are the uses of vernier caliper. Okay, let's see now. See that the uses of vernier caliper I mentioned here. First, see that the vernier caliper is used to measure the diameter of the small sphere. So now only we have explained the diameter of the small sphere. Next, external and internal diameter of narrow tubes. That means what? Tube means like a cylinder. Okay, so now you know how to take the outer diameter or inner diameter of the cylinder. Inner diameter means you want to use upper part, that is PQ, you know, in the diagram. So upper part you should use, so we can find that. Okay, and then next, the depth of the hole drilled. Okay, the depth of the holes drilled in the metal block. So this is the back side of the, I mean that end part of the, this is a tail. It's a tail part of the vernier caliper we can use. Okay, so here below jaws we can use for this purpose. Upper, especially for internal diameter, we can use the upper part. Then the depth of the holes by using the tail part of the vernier caliper we can use. Next, the small length such as the length of the cylinder. It's a main. These three points only main. So these are the uses of vernier caliper. Okay, students. I hope you understand what is vernier caliper, what about this the structure, then the each part, and then how to find the least count of the vernier caliper, then how to find the different types of errors, how to rectify, then how to take the reading also, you know, with applications. Okay, students.